for sure, speaking of Kane, and we'll have to wait and see.
Well, Kane talked about it Thursday on SmackDown, said that the monster within was finally released.
Following catching contest is scheduled for one fall. Entering the ring at a combined weight of 520 pounds, D'Lo Brown and Chaz lose.
Obviously, when The Undertaker asked for an explanation, Kane unleashed that monster, and my gosh, Kevin, it's like a tiger, a caged tiger. You never know when he's going to attack.
Well, The Undertaker suffered stitches, needed medical attention, but the scars run much deeper than that.
From Greenwich, Connecticut, at a combined weight of 547 pounds, Pete Death and Rusty the Bean Street Aussie.
So the stage is set here for a very interesting tag team contest. Low down, searching for respect, Tom, as you mentioned moments ago. The Mean Street Posse improving week after week. I smell upset.
Well, you can smell whatever it is. I think you better check the desk. But all I'm saying is Posse has a great chance of winning, but Lowdown has been doing fantastic as of late in all their matches.
And, of course, both teams, I know, are going to be intently watching what goes down at SummerSlam in the first-ever tables, ladders, and chairs matches. Edge and Christian defend the tag team titles against the Hardy Boys and the Dudley Boys.
Just think about that. Every team gets to enter that match at SummerSlam with their specialty. Edge and Christian can use chairs if they want. We know how proficient that the Hardys are with ladders. And it goes without saying that the Dudleys
can cover.
The Dudleys can use tables to their advantage as well.
Well, Edge and Christian certainly have left an emphatic mark on members of the Hardys and the Dudleys with those chairs. Thursday on SmackDown.
What is that?
Nice counter by Rodney.
What a move by Rodney. I think this guy's been training somewhere.
He's telling everybody he's a wrestler now.
Thank you.
Don't believe your own press, Rod. But, of course, we know that the indelible mark of those chairs by Edge Christian was left on Bubba Ray Dudley's, that big swollen area above his left eye. And, of course, Matt Hardy still feeling the effects of what happened to him last week on Raw. So Thursday on SmackDown, Devon teamed with Jeff Hardy with disastrous results.
Obviously, Jeff Hardy and Devon found out that if you're going to have a team together, you better team with your own brothers if it's going to work.
And Edge and Christian, I think, feel very good. They know that neither the Hardys nor the Dudleys will coexist with each other. And it is truly going to be every team for themselves. And that tables, ladders, and chairs match next Sunday night live on pay-per-view at SummerSlam. Pete Gass is in the ring now. I thought Rodney did a nice job against both members of Lowdown. Oh, there's a little bit of a shortcut tactic behind the referee's back.
Well, if the Posse learned how to use some of those shortcuts, maybe they might be a little more successful.
Oh, wait a minute now. A blind tag. Very nicely done. Look out. Oh! D'Lo caught by the neck breaker. Look at the Posse go.
What teamwork by the Posse.
Great combination of moves and cover and a two count. And, of course, a little later on here, we'll show you exactly how the extended family is now beginning to coexist. With regards to SummerSlam, Kurt Angle, Triple H putting their differences aside, apparently working together with really disastrous results for The Rock.
Yeah, The Rock doesn't even have to be pinned at SummerSlam to lose the championship. That bodes well for Kurt Angle and Triple H right now, especially since it appears they are on the same page.
Another nice tag team combination maneuver. Cover, Pete Gass this time gets the two count. Of course, the stage was set for war. I thought Monday, Kurt Angle went to the ring, and Triple H came out. Shane McMahon trying to be the cooler head prevailing. And eventually, Mick Foley stuck those three in a six-man tag against The Rock and the Dudleys. But then Kurt wanted to go try to, I guess, talk to the late-arriving Stephanie McMahon-Helmsley. And from there, was it the kiss of death?
Well, I don't know about kiss of death. I mean, that was just a friendly peck of a cheek. There's nothing wrong with that.
I don't know what Kurt Angle's motivations were, but from there, Triple H had seen the whole thing develop. And boy, that sent Stephanie McMahon leaving the arena in tears. What does she do, though? She gets on the horn with dear old daddy.
Wow.
Boy, Mr. McMahon arrived at the arena. Mr. McMahon, we understand, was in town on business. Happened to be close by the arena for Raw Monday night.
It bothers me that both Triple H and Mr. McMahon would even question Kurt's integrity. I don't think he means anything else by it except that Stephanie is a close friend.
I think Kurt Angle is an enormous hypocrite.
Oh, wait just a minute.
He's talking about integrity, and then at the same time, he's kissing.
Ann Helmsley, a beautiful young woman, out in the rain. He had the umbrella waiting for her.
What a nice handshake.
Why not?
A get well move.
Oh, come on.
A nice little gesture. You don't have to kiss a married woman. I don't care about that, Tom. What I do care about is the fact that the odds are stacked greatly against The Rock at SummerSlam in that triple threat match. Both Rodney and D'Lo Brown are down. This has been a war between Lowdown and the Main Street Posse. As we said, we'll show you all the highlights from Raw and SmackDown in just moments. How The Rock really has his championship in peril with Triple H and Kurt Angle apparently working together. Tag made, both sides, here we go. Chaz is in. Pete Gass is in. Pete Gass is down. Chaz has the lead. Rodney's down. Oh, Chaz is looking great. Boots in the midsection now, and Chaz taking Rodney up for the ride. Jackhammer. Chaz fighting both members of the Mean Street Posse while D'Lo Brown recovers out on the apron.
Chaz not doing a bad job at all.
Great DDT there.
Oh,
it would have been three if Rodney didn't come in to make the save. This match now really breaking down.
Kiyota needs to get control of this one.
All four men are in. Paired off on opposite sides. What's going to happen here?
Oh, wow!
Great reaction by the Posse. Now Pete Gass is going to the top rope. High rent district for Pete.
Not sure this is a good move.
Chaz picks and pay for it. D'Lo loading up on the other side. Rodney down on the floor, unable to stop this. Check this out, everybody.
Whoa!
Oh, my!